I am here to do my what's in my hospital bag because at some point this baby's coming. Hello. You may recognize this outfit from my 40-week update because I am recording on the same day and I was too lazy to change. So I do look the same. So I'm gonna try to go through this as quickly as possible. Obviously, because I live in Canada, some of the things that I'm bringing are probably things that you may not need if you're watching from the States or Australia or the UK. But I just thought I would do this because I might be helpful to somebody out there. I know I was looking for specifically Canadian what's in my hospital bag, and this is for my second child. So I honestly don't really remember what I brought for my first child. It was 5 years ago, and I don't really remember. So I'm sorry that I don't remember, but I don't. So I'm going to have my little piece of luggage here, and I'm just bringing one piece of luggage plus my purse. I do have a diaper bag, but I'm just not even dealing with that when there's the car seat, my purse, this. I might even move my purse stuff into this so that I only have one bag, because to me, the less bags means the less chance of forgetting stuff. So, first of all, I have a little gift from baby brother to baby boy. He doesn't know about it yet. So if he does come into the hospital, we'll give it to him then. The hospital will be out of there in a few hours, then we might just give it to him at home. I have a lot of these bars. These are probably gonna be mostly for either me afterwards or for Isaac during, my husband, or for my support team. So I bought a whole bunch of those. I doubt I would need these because I'm probably going to use some other stuff, but I did buy some pads, and they're big nasty pads because I found that even like the ultra thin ones from Always and stuff are horrible. You want the most natural cotton feeling ones because, girlfriend, you're going to be bleeding and you're going to be bleeding for a long time. I bled for 6 weeks after my first baby. So you can bleed for up to 6 weeks, and trust me, you do not want plastic down there. I did bring soothers, even though I doubt I will need them. I have my wireless headphones to Bluetooth with my phone because I have music on my phone, just mostly like Celtic and really relaxing music. Most of the stuff that I, like toiletries and stuff, I'm just gonna grab and go. But I do have a couple things. I do have, this is my favorite shampoo and conditioner right now. And I actually got a sample in the mail and I was like, okay, I'll bring this in case I get to have a shower at the hospital. I am also bringing this. Anyways, this is Earth Mama Angel Baby Mama's Nipple Butter. And I've heard rave reviews about it. I used lanolin cream last time, but I thought I would try this because this is a little bit healthier from what I understand. I have a little jar of honey. If I get to the hospital and I need energy, they don't usually let you eat anything, but this is considered liquid, so I can actually take a spoonful of this and get a boost of energy if I need to right before I'm pushing or something. I have a little baggie of on flame tea lights and votives because I don't know if I'll want these. I'll want the lights off probably during labor, and I know that it's really nice to have some ambiance. Instead of just having the lights off, so I thought I would bring a few of these so I can have some light. I have a massive pair of black undies because, you know, that's gonna be fun. I actually have like this top that I'm just gonna wear instead of a bra. I think I'm just gonna wear this kind of spandex. It's like a belly band, but I'm just gonna wear it as a bra. Got this idea from Elle Lindquist. She had done that for, I think, her last birth. I'll link a video to her birth or what's in her hospital bag. You'll see a card somewhere for that. But yeah, I think I'm going to try that because I like the idea. There's no wire or anything in it, and you can just pull it down, pull it up, whatever. If you need to expose yourself, you can. But I just like this. It's wire-free and just kind of pull it on and off. I have a going away outfit, just a nice plaid shirt, comfy. I have really comfy, just some old jogging pants that I like, or you know, joggers. They are super unfancy. This is kind of cutting my head off. There we go. They're super non-fancy. They're super ugly. They're super comfy. Score. Have a nursing bra. I have a nursing tank top. Just clip down, motherhood, maternity. I have oil so they can do perineal massage. Perennial? Whatever. Massage down there to help stretch everything out. I have a house coat, so in case I have to, in case I'm staying there long enough for visitors or I have to walk the halls, I can have my own house coat with me instead of one of their creepy ones. I have a nightie for the earlier probably stages when I actually care about modesty. There's probably going to be a time where I don't care whether this is on or not, but I thought it might as wrinkly. It's been in there for a while, but it's just a nice deep V so I can pull down and nurse. I can also wear it after birth if I decide not to wear it during the birth. I have a couple things of coconut water because we all know we need some electrolytes and energy minerals and stuff after we've been going through that rigmarole. So I have a couple bottles of that. I have all my paperwork here, my midwives. I have a spray bottle so that they can mist my face. And I also have some oils. These are not all the oils I'm gonna bring, so I'll probably bring lavender and thieves, but I use those every day pretty much, so I haven't been able to pack them away. So the ones I'm bringing, which I don't know which ones I'm going to use. I guess I could do a video afterwards of what I use, but I'm bringing Dragon Thyme, Stress Away Joy, Northern Lights Black Spruce, and Valor. And I've heard really great things about the last two, especially helping during transition and pushing, because they give you so much strength. I'm not sure about the Dragon Thyme one. It's got a lot of stuff that's good for your hormones and everything, but I was thinking possibly after, when I'm super hormonal, it might be something good to rub behind my ears, on the insides of my feet, because that's where you're supposed to rub it, and it will maybe help calm me down. They soak up water, so they're like little towels. So yeah, that's basically everything for me. As I said, except for my toiletries and wallet. I'm not sure how much recording we're going to do of the birth, but I would like to record. So we do have the camera and batteries and extra SIM card and everything all sitting waiting to go. But because I'm still recording, obviously that can't go in because we only have one camera right now. And I also have a pair of socks and deodorant. Sorry, whoops. Crucial. Oh, I have diapers for a little man. I'm bringing a size 1. I think I might put in 2. I haven't actually done this, but my first son was 9.5 pounds when he was born, and let me tell you, he did not need newborn. The newborn diapers actually cut off the circulation to the legs. He was a chunky monkey. So I'm assuming it's going to be the same story, especially because I'm going to be going overdue with this one, that we don't need to have newborn diapers. But I guess I could throw in a couple because I do have some. I have a pair of socks for him and a little hat. I'm also really not into hats. If he's like his brother and me, we sweat from our heads. That's where I start sweating if I'm hot. And Josiah was just always way too hot to put a hat on. He overheated all the time, but I still have one just in case. I have a cover for the, this is like a breastfeeding cover, or you can also use it to cover the car seat. I cannot think of words I'm trying to say. So it's kind of multi-use that way. And I have an Aiden and a Nye, is that how you say it? Aiden and a Nye, a swaddle blanket. I might actually bring another one because just so I could roll it up and put it around his head when he's in the car seat. And then I have a couple little 0 to 3 onesies. I have a blue one and I have the brown one. And then I have a newborn sleeper, even though I'm pretty sure he'll be too big for that, because this is only up to 7 pounds. And then I have, this is the going away one I actually bought for him. So I just love the color green. And of course I just got lipstick all over it. What a fail. This is my hospital bag. And I feel like now I'm like, really, that's all you're packing? But again, I'm only planning on being in the hospital hopefully for about 3 hours after I give birth. And then we get to go home, hopefully, as long as everything goes smoothly. So I'm not planning a really long stay. I will obviously have to send someone back to get more stuff if I do have to stay longer, and that's totally fine. That is my hospital bag. I hope that you found this useful. Have my slippers in here, which are just Crocs. I'm gonna pop those in the front though before I leave. I don't know if there's anything, I'm probably missing something, but you guys can tell me. So leave comments of what you think is a necessity. Leave a comment on what you think I shouldn't be bringing, or what you are like, oh, I'm so glad you said that because I need to bring that. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Thumbs up if you did, and subscribe and hit the bell if you want to see more videos. They hopefully will change from being maternity videos to actually new baby and stuff. I've got some other cool ideas for my decluttering series. And so yeah, come along for the ride if you want. Later, guys. It's so pretty as we float amongst the stars. You will shine so bright.